Hello, in this video I'd like to go over how to analyze data in JMP for an example that eventually leads to a 2x3 independent measures ANOVA, also known as between subjects ANOVA. I'd like to use the beer goggles effect data slightly modified from Andy Field's example. So here's the situation. An anthropologist was interested in the effects of alcohol on mate selection in nightclubs. Her rationale was that after alcohol had been consumed, subjective perceptions of physical attractiveness would be more inaccurate, the well-known beer goggles effect. She was also interested in whether this effect was different for men and for women. She picked 48 students, 24 male and 24 female. She then took groups of 8 students to a nightclub and gave them no alcohol, so a placebo drink, 2 pints of a strong lager or 4 pints. At the end of the night, she took a photograph of each person that the participant was chatting up, and then got a pool of independent judges to assess the attractiveness of the person in each photograph. So here we have the actual data. So 2 levels for sex, male or female, alcohol, we have 3 levels, 0, 2, or 4, and then attractiveness ratings. So before doing anything else, let's just check that the data is properly formatted and labeled here. So sex is nominal, that makes sense. Alcohol level is actually numeric data, so 0, 2, or 4, but we model it here as nominal because we want to treat it as an independent variable. And attractiveness rating is numeric, it's more or less continuous, so this all makes sense. So, as usual, let's always start with the distribution just to look at the data, make sure everything makes sense. You can also check whether the groups are roughly equal set up. Okay, so you can see that we have equal groups of male and female. You can see that these are also looked in the data file. The alcohol level is also equally distributed. So that's good. Can we select this? So let's take a look at the normality effect, so whether the data is normally distributed. So we can do a normality test here, which gives us the curve here, normal distribution, test positive fit, and it's a called normal quartile plot. So ideally, it should be really on the starting line. If it was normally distributed, it looks okay here. It's a little bit going sideways here, going a little bit below. Here, a little bit above here, so it might be a bit of an effect. You can test this more formally by doing a goodness of fit test here. And the Shapiro-Wilk W test tells you okay, it's a little bit below there, so the mapping issue. So, different things you can do. You can try and adjust the tests you run, or you can kind of assume that the ANOVA is robust enough against violations of the assumption of normality, which is tends to be normal, especially if you have equal group sizes. So next thing we can do is actually graph the data so we get a better impression of it. So on the y-axis we have our dependent variable, alcohol we can put down here. Often I like to just show not only the individual data points, but also directly take a look at the mean and the confidence interval to get a really good feel for the data. Maybe even add a connecting line between here. And if we add sex into the plot here, we already get a pretty good idea of what's going on with the data. So for females here in blue, it seems that the attractiveness ratings go a little bit down. And for the males, initially they seem to be a tiny bit higher, but then drop for 4 beers. You can also see that the confidence interval here is a bit larger than for females, so we might need to check whether the assumption of homogeneity of variances is met before we do anything else.